Hello, dear students. I am happy to explain a few more concepts of Employees Provident Fund. Already, I have explained you about Statutory Provident Fund and Recognized Provident Fund. So, in this video, we will cover two more important types. One is Unrecognized Provident Fund and other one is Superannuation Fund. So, already you know, it's about giving the financial security to the employees at the end of their career. So, SPF benefits the government employees and RPF benefits the private employees. Similarly, there is another provident fund scheme which is going to help the private employees only, that is unrecognized provident fund. So, this unrecognized provident fund is also a fund where contributions will be made by both employer and employee. But the different thing about this scheme is that it is not recognized by the Commissioner of Income Tax. So, when it is recognized by the Commissioner of Income Tax, it becomes RPF. Establishment of the fund remains same. If it is recognized by the Commissioner of Income Tax, it becomes RPF. If it is not recognized, then it will become the unrecognized provident fund. Along with that, this scheme also has certain drawbacks. When we go through the provisions of this scheme, this is not that beneficial to the employees when compared to SPF or RPF. The provisions of this scheme are like this. The employee's contribution is included in salary. So, just like SPF and RPF, here also, whatever employee contributes to this fund is part of his salary, is part of his gross salary, and it will be included while computing the taxability or computing total salary for the purpose of taxation. And the different thing is that whatever he has contributed, he is not eligible to claim it as a deduction, just like SPF or RPF. So, that will come to the that we'll come to know about it later. Next important point is about employee's contribution. Employer's contribution. After employee's contribution, it is employer's contribution. Employer's contribution and interest on employer's contribution or interest accumulated on the fund. There is a change in this regard. What happens in the case of SPF and RPF is that in SPF, it is fully exempt. In the case of RPF, it is exempt up to 12%. But in the case of URPF, that is Unrecognized Provident Fund, contribution by employer and interest on URPF, both are ignored. Means they are not taxed, they are not exempted, they are ignored till the employee dies or retires. Only at the time of the death of the employee or when employee retires, only on those two circumstances, URPF will be converted into RPF. So, then only it will get the recognition of being RPF. When those two incidents takes place, retirement or death of the employee, URPF will be converted into RPF, and upon that, the contribution as well as interest will be taxed in the hands of the employee. And until then, the next provision tells us that whatever the interest which is there from that account or from that fund is taxed under section 56. 56 is for income from other sources. So, I repeat, the contribution of employer as well as interest on URPF, both will be ignored till the employee dies or retires or URPF is converted into RPF. And after that, it will get the recognition of RPF, or once it gets the recognition of RPF, then the usual provisions of RPF will be applicable to URPF as well. And with regard to interest, it is taxable in the hands of the assessee only under section 56. And last important point about this provident fund scheme is about the eligibility for claiming deduction. As I have said in the beginning, this is not a fund which is recognized by the government or by the income tax department. That's why it has certain drawbacks. One such drawback is that this is not or the contribution made by the employee towards this fund is not eligible for deduction under section 80C. You know, in the case of SPF or RPF, employee's contribution is eligible for deduction. Means he can reduce his tax burden by claiming that amount as a deduction. But under URPF, if you have contributed for URPF, then you are not eligible to claim it as a deduction. As it is unrecognized, government will not allow you to deduct this from deduct under 80C. Means to that extent, every month whatever you have contributed will become the part of salary for taxation purpose. And as there is no deduction, you will be paying the tax for this portion of your contribution towards URPF. So, this is the drawback of this fund. So, ultimately URPF is for private employees, they can make use of this fund they can contribute to this fund, but they have to keep one thing in mind: unless it becomes RPF or unless it is recognized by the Commissioner of Income Tax, there are no such benefits or important benefits like other provident fund schemes. So the next fund I am going to explain in this video is regarding the ASF, that is Approved Superannuation Fund. Approved Superannuation Fund is also a fund which is not that popular like SPF or RPF, and the purpose of this fund is totally different. This fund is not for retirement actually. So you can understand, when employees are working in industries or manufacturing units, they may meet with accidents or injuries. Whenever they meet with certain contingencies or such type of incidents, it is important to protect them, it is important to help them. So to protect or help such employees, a fund has been established, and that fund is Approved Superannuation Fund. So this is also a fund which is recognized by the government. This was established in the year 1968 as per the Finance Act of the government. And in this fund, the beauty of this fund is that in the case of RPF, SPF or URPF, amount will be contributed by the employee and employer, and it can be withdrawn by the employee at the time of retirement or death. But here it can be withdrawn by the employee at the time of happening of certain contingencies. And in this fund, or in this fund, the amount you want to withdraw cannot be withdrawn in one lump sum. It can be withdrawn in annuities, means once in a year. If you meet with certain accidents or injuries, then after that, whatever it is accumulated in this fund will be given to you as annuities, means once in a year you can withdraw the amount, not in one lump sum at one time. So that's the difference of this fund. And employer's contribution, whatever employee contributes is part of his salary, it is taxable. Whatever employer contributes, it is taxable if it is above 1 lakh. Means if employer's contribution is above 1 lakh towards this fund in that year, then above 1 lakh, whatever it is there, it is taxable. Below 1 lakh, it is exempt from tax, means it will not be included with the salary of the employee for the purpose of taxation. And the next important provision of this fund is regarding the contribution to ASF. On death or the employee become incapacitated to work, he is fully exempt from tax. That means whatever you have contributed to this fund, the accumulated balance in this fund, whatever you receive at the time of the death of the employee or employee being or employee becoming incapacitated, his inability to work, at that time whatever you receive is fully exempt from tax. That's the advantage for the employee. So certainly he can make use of this facility. And last important point about this fund is eligibility to claim the deductions. Just like SPF, RPF, in this fund also, he is eligible to claim the deduction under section 80C. So whatever he contributes as an employee towards this fund, he can claim it as a deduction under section 80C and he can reduce the tax burden. So Approved Superannuation Fund is also a beneficial fund for the employee. He can contribute to this fund so that he can safeguard his interest in the case of certain contingencies which may occur when he is working in the organization. Both URPF and ASF are not that popular, but still they are beneficial to the employees. With this, I have covered two important types of EPFs in this video. Thank you for watching.